this video, I'm going to show you how to generate ragas, the music you heard at the start of this video, using derivatives for regular expressions, Ableton Live, Max MSP, and JavaScript. Here we have Ableton Live. It is a digital audio workstation, which is just software you use to make music. Down here we can see the vertical piano roll, and the squares represent notes placed on the horizontal timeline. Up here we can see a clip, which is just a container for these notes. And down here we can see the instrument, which is a slightly modified electric piano one soft. Let's hear what it sounds like. So that was me playing manually, but we can also play our clip, which is just a bunch of C notes. Before we send the notes to our instrument, we can pre-process them using a randomizer, which scales the notes up and down randomly. Let's hear what that sounds like. And when we turn the randomizer off, we should hear just the C notes again. And when we turn the randomizer on, we should hear the random notes again. Okay, that's enough of that noise. Now what we want to do is filter the random notes and only allow the notes that are in the Raga through. We're going to do this using a plugin we've created using Max MSP. Now, Max MSP is a whole nother piece of software that is embedded inside Ableton Live. It is a flow-based programming language that you can use to create your own devices. And in this case, we've used it to create a filter for MIDI notes. This component's used to get the note in, then it flows to our JavaScript logic, which I will explain later. And we have some custom filter logic. And then we go out to make note, which sends a note on and note off MIDI signal to note out. Now, inside Max MSP, we can embed JavaScript and we can look at the source. At the top, we can see the grammar for our Raga in example devs. Below, we can see where the note is received from Max MSP. We convert the note to a string. We take the derivative of our current state with respect to the note string. We simplify our new state, and we check that our new state is satisfiable. We do this to make sure that we don't end up in some failure state by accident. If the new state is satisfiable, then we assign the new state to the current state. Otherwise, we set the note to zero before we send it to the outlet, where our custom filter logic will make sure not to send it on to the electric soft piano. Now let's take a look at the rest of the code. Here we have our derivative function. So the derivative of empty is the empty set. The derivative of empty set is always the empty set. The derivative of some character, if it's equal, is empty. Otherwise, it's the empty set. And then we have or and concat and zero more and reference. The details of the derivative function I hope to cover in another video. Now we also have a new satisfiability function, which returns true if we can reach an accepting state, like empty. Empty state is obviously not an accepting state. A character, if we get the right character, it can be accepting. Or is satisfiable if the left side or the right side is satisfiable. Whereas concat, both sides have to be satisfiable. Zero more is always satisfiable since it is an accepting state. And finally, reference has to recurse. We'll have another video on the core algorithm, which includes the simplify function and the nullable function. We have some constructors for our different operators. And at the top, we have our grammar for our Raga stored in example devs. I hope to explain this grammar and Ragas in a prequel video. And finally, our start state is stored in current state. And that is all the JavaScript code we need for our filter. Now if we close it all up, we can hear what it sounds like. Here we can see the random notes coming into the filter, and here we can see the notes that are actually played and going out of the filter. I find this music quite relaxing, so I will post a video that is just the generated music, another prequel video that explains the theory behind Ragas, and finally the really simple core algorithm that is the derivative function for regular expressions and context-free grammars. See you in the next video.